city of Puyallup is celebrating its 125th birthday. The city actually predates the state of Washington. Brenda Arline gives us a glimpse of Puyallup's founding.
It began with the trees. Forests so dense that some homesteaders in 1877 didn't even know there was a town sprouting up in the valley below. Businessman James P. Stewart was laying down the grids of Franklin on the north side of the Northern Pacific Railroad track. Farmer Ezra Meeker was platting Puyallup to the south.
A small area, roughly 20 acres, from the powerhouse here to the Presbyterian Church, two streets wide, just to lay down a marker and say, we think this ought to be a community. Some folks said, we'll call it Meekerville, and he said, not on your life, and picked Puyallup as the name, and it's the only one of its kind.
Puyallup is a native word meaning welcoming or generous people. The rich volcanic soil of the Puyallup Valley was more than generous to the fledgling farmers. Following Ezra's lead, more than 100 farmers were filling the valley with hops and hop kilns. By 1888, the annual yield was nearly 1 million pounds. The town had also doubled in size, and community leaders on both sides of the railroad track realized they needed a more formal structure.
They took a petition and went before a judge in Tacoma, and he said, sure, why not?
Not is what the Supreme Court of the new state of Washington said in 1890, throwing out the incorporation as unconstitutional. Undaunted, the citizens held a new election that August, and Ezra Meeker became the first mayor of Puyallup's second christening.
In early 1893, the Commercial Club, which is the forerunner of the Chamber of Commerce, started on a drive to petition the legislature to move the state capital to Puyallup, where it properly belonged.
The state capital didn't move, but Puyallup was the hops capital of the world, and Ezra Meeker was called the Hop King. It all came crashing down in 1893 as hop lice and a national depression all but ended the hop fortunes. But the frontier fortitude of the Puyallup folk merely asked, what's next?
They were not poor people. They were not rich people, but they were middle-class folks with middle-class values who left everything behind, paid a good deal of money for their outfits, came out here and reestablished the same way of life that they had.
The rich soil proved equally suited for cultivating bulbs and berries. By the late 1920s, the Puyallup Valley was filled with daffodils. To use and celebrate the blooming flowers, the Daffodil Festival began in 1926, and the parade route through Tacoma, Puyallup, Sumner, and Orting was established in 1934. But if anything was going to replace the glory days of hops, it was berries. Raspberries, blackberries, and marionberries, some of the world's finest, were grown here, one-fifth of the nation's production. Each summer, Puyallup's population swelled as pickers took to the fields from all over the region.
You had a small building on your property, and you'd bring in one of these families from Tacoma or farther away, and they would spend the summer picking your berries and living here in the rural community.
I remember growing up in the buses, taking kids in the summer to go pick fruit. You know, they had the white buses with the strawberries on it, and you don't see that today.
In 1900, C.J. Stewart invented a fruit box, cooled by ice and then loaded on a train, sending Puyallup fruit, jams, and jellies across the country. In 1933, local canneries handled nearly 15 million pounds of berries and small fruit. World War II profoundly changed America's cities and towns. Industrial jobs diminished the commercial role of agriculture. Residents began commuting to work, and the golden age of the automobile reshaped and redirected both business and customers. Puyallup had another forceful push into the modern world, the 1949 earthquake. The 7.1 tumbler sent the old brick and mortar buildings crashing to the street. From the rubble, a new building spree and modernization changed the face of Puyallup, but not its spirit. The 125th anniversary celebrations are designed to promote and remember Puyallup's unique personality.
There are enough things in this community, wonderful old houses, the John Lotz House, which is a national historic site, the earliest plank house in the valley, beautiful old buildings that should at least make you ask the question, what had been here, what was this community, how much of it is left.
For Pierce County Talks, I'm Brenda Arline.
Puyallup's 125th celebration includes fun and informative activities throughout the summer. Joining me to talk about the plans are Brenda Arline and Benjii Bittle. Welcome to the studio.
Thanks, Dave. Thank
you. So, Brenda, give us a thumbnail sketch, if you would, of the activities that are planned for the summer.
Well, we do have activities planned for the summer, but we were so excited we couldn't wait until the summer. We have the ball rolling already. The members of the City Council planted a giant sequoia in Bradley Lake Park last month as part of Arbor Day. And also, we've been doing a Throwback Thursdays social media campaign sharing historic photos of the city, which has been great fun because so many people haven't seen those pictures before. And as the summer proceeds, Meeker Days will feature the 125th celebration as its featured theme. And then in August, we're going to have a fun main event in Pioneer Park.
And that's going to be kind of a history-related activity.
Yes.
In August.
Very much so. We'll have historical displays, we'll have a slideshow of photographs, we'll have live music, and we have some very good speakers lined up who will tell us about and entertain us about Puyallup and its history and how it came to be the wonderful place it is today.
Excellent. Benjii, you are the man of Meeker Days.
I am.
This year it coincides with the U.S. Open. How do you think that's going to affect the celebration?
It's really exciting. I think this is our chance to really show off Puyallup to a much larger market. A lot of the folks who are reporting on the USGA are actually staying in Puyallup hotels. So I'm working with them to do establishing shots and get some good footage of Puyallup before they get out there and get onto the golf course. And then during the festival itself, they're going to be up to their eyeballs in UP shooting golf footage. But I'm hoping a lot of those attendees come down and have a beer after they're out of the course all day, dance to some dance bands, and have fun with us.
Maybe you can put up a blockade so the bus has to stop downtown
and let
everybody off.
I like it. Absolutely. We'll work with the police department, just pull them right over at the Meeker Days stop.
Yeah. How will Meeker Days celebrate the 125th anniversary? Anything new and different?
Yeah, absolutely. So Andy Anderson, who is at the Puyallup Historical Society at Meeker Mansion, has been an invaluable resource, and he's really the expert. I'm just throwing the party. He's the content, really. So Andy's going to have a booth right at the Ezra Meeker statue in Pioneer Park, where there's grapevines that were from the original Meeker Days planted there. He's going to have artifacts. He's going to have volunteers out there talking about the 125th with families. And I think it's going to be a really wonderful, low-key way for people to get their hands on the founding of Puyallup and how it's different, how it's the same as it is today. And throughout the whole festival, we'll have different kinds of activities. There's an actor who portrays Ezra Meeker, so we're going to get him involved in some ways. We're going to have all of the elected officials there in Puyallup participate in an opening ceremony where we officially launch things and commemorate the 125th. And then a little informal stuff, too. We're partnering with the city, who has a fabulous social media campaign that we're going to be partnering on 100 things, 125 things that I love about Puyallup. So that'll be a great lead-in for Meeker Days and help people to identify what it is that they love about living, working, shopping in Puyallup.
Excellent. Outside of the 125th anniversary in the U.S. Open, what else will be new or different at Meeker Days this year over last year?
Yeah, you bet. So some of the challenges of having the USGA is hotel rooms are very few and far between and very expensive. So what that meant on a practical level for me is I'm booking a lot of local talent this year. So it really forced me to dive deep and find really great people in Puyallup that folks might not have heard of before to feature. And we've done that. I'm really excited about some of the local groups. And then we have some great regional talent coming up from Portland and down from Seattle to play as well that are in drive time. So I would say that's one of the things, is really a focus on what's unique and special and local this year. Another is the spray park is opening that the Kiwanis are building right in the middle of Pioneer Park. And that's right in the middle of the Meeker Days footprint, which adds a huge water element and a lot of wet kids. So that changes the dynamic a bit, but in a good way. It's going to be a huge draw. And that whole Pioneer Park area is really going to be dedicated to families and family entertainment in a way that we haven't been able to do before. We've been lucky enough to partner with some philanthropic dollars from the Bamford Foundation, from the Muckleshoots, from the Puyallups, and those dollars are helping us really amp up the quality of what we're offering to families out there this year, which I'm very excited about. And then the flip side of that is the main stage and the beer gardens and wine gardens and all the activities for the adults. You know, there is a segment of the community that wants to go and not be surrounded
surrounded by wet three-year-olds, right? As delightful as that is. And so for them, I really want to have a robust experience where there's great music happening on the main stage. They can sit in the beer garden and relax for a while, or they can get in front of the stage and dance till 9 or 10 at night and then go out to the bars in Puyallup.
Sounds fun. Brenda, you mentioned the Pioneer Park and so forth. That's where the farmer's market is located. And how is the farmer's market going to play into the 125th anniversary?
Yes. Well, the farmer's market is such a great tie-in to Puyallup's agricultural past, and it's one of the best farmer's markets in the state, if not the best, if you ask, depending on who you ask. The farmer's market will also have a great weekend that weekend. Uh-huh. And one of the things that I'm most excited about, and I get even more excited about when I hear Benjii talk, because he's such a great proponent of the downtown, is to have all these people descend on Puyallup for the open, and probably a lot of them have not been to Puyallup before. Mm-hmm. And the downtown is just going to be crackling
it
and
is.
Buzzing with activities and so much fun that weekend. And
yeah.
It's really exciting for me to be able to show it off in that way
yeah.
with the farmer's market and Meeker Days yeah. and everything else that we have going on downtown. So.
And the Meeker Mansion is going to be doing some things for the 125th anniversary, particularly in the month of August.
Yes.
Any idea on that?
They have a weeks-long plan of activities for that week during the main event. They're going to have a magical history tour. They're going to have lectures. They're planning an old-fashioned softball game. They're going to have a top-to-bottom tour of the mansion, which is rare. Normally, they only have the mansion open for parts of it, but they're going to actually take people from the basement all the way up to the top. That will be fun, too. They have lots of good things planned.
It's an amazing place. Andy Anderson, who I mentioned before, I read in the paper last November, he was finding 100 objects that kind of defined Puyallup and the experience, everything from, you know, chicken manufacturing stuff to hops things. It's amazing. And so he's got his fingers in just about everything, and it all kind of comes together historically at Meeker Mansion. You ask about the markets. They started two Saturdays ago, and it's going gangbusters in Pioneer Park. I was there last week, and it was absolutely thronged with people, which is fantastic. And right before Meeker Day starts on June 18th, they'll be adding a Thursday night market for the first time this year, which is really exciting because that's the night that concerts happen in the park as well.
Mm-hmm.
So there will be concerts and markets in the park all summer on Thursday evenings, too.
Puyallup's the place to go this summer, it sounds like.
It certainly will be.
Congratulations on 125th. Happy birthday to
I don't look more than 76, do
I? Know. You're doing great, Benjii. Thank you for joining us, and good luck with all those festivities.
Thanks,
Thank
Dave.
You.
And that wraps up this edition of Pierce County Talks. Thank you for watching. You can watch this program again and share it with friends anytime on our website, piercecountytv.org. And on our mobile app for smartphones and tablets. I'm Dave Hinman. So long.